If you're going to make an illustration, you must take poetry and song into it.
Sister, you give me my best self. Your toast naming what I want to be. What you show me, I already am. Reflect. Help me see my other side. The parts that start to slip away with living. Hold them for me, and I will do the same for you. So someday all this may break loose. What you show me, what I show you. This toast naming what we long for. Our best selves intertwined. Intertwined our best selves. This toast naming what we long for. What I show you, what you show me. So someday all this may break loose, hold them for me, and I will do the same for you. The parts that start to slip away with living. Reflect. Help me see my other side. Your toast naming what I want to be. What you show me, I already am. Sister, you give me my best self.
This job is not complex. Only the muddle of our minds is complex. The job is simple. If the time spent before a canvas is unduly long compared to results achieved, you'll find it spent in digging self out of the way so that the picture can stand forth in all its loveliness.
Instead of thinking so much, let down the portals of your mind and look at it.
Strength.
Strength.
Woman fixing fence.
Strength. Woman fixing fence.
I love how you lean away from that post.
Nothing holding you up but the force of your pull. You are your own anchor.
You're your own anchor.
You are your own anchor.
Hair flying in the wind as the storm picks up.
And you not even needing a coat.
Not that anyone's offering.
That rap tap.
Rap tap.
That rap tap, wrist tapping man.
Driving nails. Girl. Girl.
Girl. If you had that thing, you'd have your arm cocked back overhead.
If you had that thing,
arm cocked back overhead.
Ready,
ready to deliver.
Ready,
ready to deliver.
Go.
That rap tap, wrist tapping man.
That rap tap,
driving nails.
I love how you ran away from that post.
Ready.
Girl,
you are your own anchor. You are your own anchor.
You are your own anchor.
Hair flying in the wind.
Ready. Strength.
Strength. Ready to deliver a blow worth noting.
Concerned so with the pattern that you forget the humanity. Never forgetful of loveliness, nor is neglectful of it.
Protectiveness. Mother, you stand guard among the prairie flowers, phlox, scarlet milkweed, wild roses, spiderwort. Your arm held back as a hen gathers her chicks, protecting these young children, your best things, with shears too dull for mending. Leaning close, sister knows your fear. She's learning the art of watchfulness. Mother, tell us what you see as you slant-eye the horizon. Is it something there or something past that's tracking you? Sister knows your fear. Left behind, bare, tiny graves you rolled past on the slow way west. Cellar's dug. Mother, tell us what you see. Gardens of mothers and sisters left behind. Your best things.
Contribute something of art and romance to the casual fact. Do one thing only and put all you have into that one thing. Be a little more of the poet. Be sentimental. Think, but think artistically, not intellectually. When the intellect comes in, art goes out.
My child, holding you in this firelight, we're still warm. But now I know that this solid flesh we're brought into, that I have brought you to, is just a living unto death, a short time, either way, whether stolen early or lulled by and by the passage of time, that it does not as I'd hoped, lie outside. And yet now, here you are, warm, wriggly, demanding my attentions, my gaze. And I see if I shirk from this truth, pacify myself with lies, I risk missing richness. My God, I fear that knowing this is too much to hold alone. Faceless, she sits alone in the seat of privilege her new husband proffered as he hoisted her onto its cold metal seat. Here, love, he smiled and sighed at his kindness, at his plan to soften her, warm her to him. A few nice words, a few kind looks, a new bolt of fabric if need be, gravy on the cake of security. Ahead, he nearly whistles as he swaggers, leading his gaunt oxen, slings his upright stave over his shoulder for show and luck, as she wishes for a rag-tied wheel to watch the miles home roll away.
Thank you.
worry about the figures has robbed the picture of beauty. Beauty goes right along with conviction. Let's keep worry and fear out of our pictures. In spite of the girl, this is still life. It makes me feel as though you stood outside of it and painted it at arm's length. You admire the pillows more than you do the girl, which isn't very complimentary to her. You've taken the adornment and made that important. But you're afraid of the girl. I wish we didn't work so hard. We're good and conscientious. We all act as though we're duty about art. It should be an abundant overflowing. You're here to have fun. This is very nice indeed. Full of light and color and atmosphere. Solid and real. I feel it is a joyous record of your being. In this, I feel too much striving and wondering if this or that should be this or that way. Paint it because you love it. Let your picture be an expression of your love. I don't say it's easy, but it's well worth trying to achieve. And there's no point in painting them if you don't love them. Paint a little less of the facts and a little more of the spirit. Look a little at the model and a lot inside. Paint more with feeling than with thought. In making a picture, you should excite interest, not educate. Let the colleges do that.
After hours of dissection, eyes dividing you into angles and shadows, you have simply withdrawn, satisfied with just yourself, shrugging off any admiration, lessening whispers of affection. I have enough of my own, you say, and turn away from even the dull caress of December sun that lingers at the window pane. Your shoulders down, not submitting, just deflecting. Curved in upon yourself, you have shed all pretense and just long to lie down. Cover yourself in these tangled sheets and yesterday's clothes and sing yourself to sleep with something between lullaby and sob.
Thank you.
It's full of mystery, and so it should be. Where light doesn't enter, there is darkness.
Thank you. Dignity. After the blizzard, you can hardly breathe standing on the top of the roof high drift, but you stay and take it in, master its boundaries. Yesterday, the whiteness had no edges. As it swirled and howled. You couldn't see 2 feet in front and dared not step outside. But today, up here, you can see where the whiteness leaves off and gray or even blue begins. And you find again the edges of your soul, this dignity you've claimed and hoarded, saved for times like this. When even lightness needs new edges. When even you must create new places to begin.
Some days, she wakes and asks herself, how here? How did I make this life? Arrange this self, muffled in so many lies and excuses. Stale hellos, false smiles. I'm weary from the aftermath of excess. I need to rise. Leave this place that leaves me exposed, yet still unseen. Need to somehow untangle. I'm weary from the aftermath of excess and need to rise. Need to leave this place that leaves me exposed, yet still unseen. Need to somehow untangle this blue, blue blanket of denial.
Now, ideas, if true, must also have intelligence. Otherwise, they'd be no part of truth. So give it credit for having intelligence. And when it comes to you for expression, realize that it has chosen you. And having intelligence, it knows the vehicle it needs. So don't think, this idea is too big for me. If it chooses you, then you can express it. Keep yourself out of it.
She had a certain sweetness, the kind that only comes from loss. A patience gifted by endurance. The long prairie winters, the dying, and the tiny graves. The hard days of working with no end in sight. When stitch after stitch seemed the easier part of the day. But now when she sits, now that she sits, she has no need to pull her shawl tight round shoulders bent to work. No need for busy hands or tongue. All is blessed rest. And in my driven days, I want to hear her say again, "Dry your eyes, child. There's no time for tears. There'll be no righteous seed begging for bread. Remember, because of great love, we are not consumed. There's newness every morning, and compassion never fails."
To be feminine is not to be weak, it's strong. Without strength, there is no tenderness.
Regality. She's a goddess, this girl. I want to honor this nonchalant boldness.
Honor this nonchalant boldness.
With a poem
worthy of beauty.
She's unadorned. No fine apparel, chariots, rare jewels, no king with the width of his face in red gold, the length of his arm in the light.
She's down to the center,
arms out for balance, unafraid, graceful and haughty, yet not.
She's a goddess.